Today, I will take discrete time Fourier transform, which is the next topic in DST, and this is very important fundamental topic where we can learn that how can we decompose a continuous and discrete periodic signals into its harmonics. So suppose we have some signal like this, which is actually discrete in nature, then using DTFS, discrete time Fourier series method, we can decompose this composite signal into its harmonic. So concept is very simple and the technique is very useful. For the purpose of frequency spectrum analysis for periodic signal, keep underline periodic signal. It is very important technique. But it is applicable to only periodic signal, not to non-periodic signal. We can apply it to any discrete time signal which is a periodic, and we can find out its Fourier coefficients, frequency and amplitude spectrum using Fourier series. So, as in last class told that discrete signal is what which is not continuous. So this may be some signal with a reference n, and some signal x of n which is discrete. For this signal, we can use these formulas I am writing here. So, x of n is equal to summation c of k, k equal to 0 to n minus 1 e to the power j 2 pi by capital N k n. So this is a Fourier series equation for x of n, any given discrete time signal. X of n, k equal to 0 to n minus 1, c of k, e to the power minus j 2 pi by capital N, small k, small n. This capital N is a fundamental period of this signal. Small k is an integer and its value will be between 0 to capital N minus 1. And n is another variable which again is between 0 to capital N minus 1. C of k is Fourier series coefficients. To find out C of k, we can use this formula, 1 upon n summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n e to the power minus j 2 pi by capital N k n. Capital N is a fundamental period of this signal. X n is your signal and with this exponent. The range of small n is between again 0 to n minus 1. So using this equation we can find out Fourier series coefficient. Once we have Fourier series coefficient, we can put these values in this equation and we will ultimately be able to find out the decomposed value of the signal. So C of K is nothing but K frequency Fourier series coefficients. So C of K is nothing but K series, K frequency Fourier series coefficient. So mathematically our task will be, first of all, for any given problem we will find out C of K by using this equation, and then we will find out x of n again by putting this value of C of K in this equation. As I said, this Fourier series is only applicable to periodic signals. When starting only, we need to find out that whether a given signal is periodic or not. If a signal is not periodic, if signal is non-periodic, in that case we need not to find out Fourier series for it. We will directly write that Fourier series does not exist for non-periodic signal. So first of all, initially to save time, we will decide that whether signal is periodic or not. Then only we will start mathematical operation. Here k is some integer, and you see we can write 2 pi by n as omega naught. We can multiply with small k this and that side, and that I can give a name as omega k. So to make this equation compact, I can use omega k instead of exponent value. So I can rewrite this equation, x of n is equal to summation c of k, for k equal to 0 to n minus 1 e to the power j omega k n, and c of k will be equal to 1 upon n from this equation. Summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n e to the power minus j omega k n. So these are the compact version of the same formulas. We will use these two formulas to find out discrete time Fourier series. Omega naught is the fundamental frequency of the signal, and is a period, fundamental period of the signal. Suppose some x of n is given to us, and that is x of n is equal to cos of 4 pi small n by 60. I can rewrite it as cos pi by 4 n. Suppose we need to find out whether this one is a periodic or not. So for this signal, we need to find out periodic condition. For any signal, if it is periodic, it will respect this equation. And if it is an angular trigonometric representation, or it is about an angular version, then the same as theta plus 2 pi will be equal to x theta. For example, sine theta plus 2 pi will be equal to sine theta. So this, if suppose x of n is periodic, then x of n plus n will be equal to x of n. It means what? This n will be integer multiple of 2 pi. So that what will happen if it is an integer multiple of 2 pi, means 4 pi, 8 pi or 2 pi itself, it will make x of n plus capital N equal to x of small n. So this equation will become sine of theta plus 2 pi is equal to sine of theta, because theta plus 360 degree is it itself. So this is the condition of periodicity. Now we will test this condition for this given problem, which is cos pi by 4 n. So I will write it like cos of pi by 4 small n plus capital N. Now this part, this angle part, pi by 4 small n plus pi by 4 capital N will be equal to pi by 4 small n when this part is equal to 2 pi multiple. When that part is a multiple of 2 pi, that time only this will become pi by 4 n. So from there, you compare these two values, pi by 4 capital N is equal to 2 pi m, or I can rewrite it, pi to pi will be cancelled, you will find n equal to 8 m. Now this m is a multiple, integer multiple, so its value will be 1, 2, 3, 4 something. If you take n equal to 1, it will become n equal to 8. For capital N equal to 1, it will become n equal to 8. So the fundamental period, or the smallest period for this given signal, is n equal to 8. So the capital value for this signal is 8. So now I can say that because signal is periodic, so DTFS, discrete time Fourier series, will exist for this signal. So we need to find out C of k and x of n. So we can proceed for the mathematical calculation for this problem. So this point should be clear that first of all, we will always find period of a given problem, If it is a periodic signal, then we will go for Riemannian calculation. So, I will take a simple example. Suppose some x of n is given to us, and that is what? 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, and then 1, 2, 1. So by looking at this given sequence, you can see that this is a periodic sequence because it is repeating itself after 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1. You see the value here, after every 3 samples, it is repeating itself. So as it is repeating itself, so it is what 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1 like this. So you see, the length of the sequence will be what 1, 2, 1. So first sample, second sample, third sample, and this position is 0 position, that is plus 1 position, is plus 2 position. So, in simple manner, I can write x of n is equal to simply 1, 2 and 1. So, by looking at this, you can say that capital N for this value is 3. After every third sample, you are getting the earlier value. So, capital N is equal to 3. So, equation of Ck for this sequence will be 1 by n summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n e to the power minus j 2 pi by k small n k. You can check your formula, there is the same formula here, c of k. So capital N is equal to 3, so this will become what? 1 by 3 summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1, 3 minus 1, that is 2 x of n e to the power minus j 2 pi small n, sorry, it should be capital N, 2 pi by capital N k. So now capital N is 3 only, so I can write 3 here. So equation is of 1 by 3 n equal to 0 to 2 x of n e to the power minus j 2 pi n by 3. Alright, again I can take this 1 by 3 outside and I can open the summation here. So I will put n equal to 0, then n equal to 1, then n equal to 2. So I will write x of 0 e to the power 0 plus x of 1 e to the power minus j 2 pi by 3 k plus x of 2 e to the power minus j 2 pi by 3 small n equal to 1, so it is here. Now n equal to 2, so in this term it will become dot 2 k. What I did here, I have opened up this summation. It is n equal to 0 to 2, so I am writing x 0, 0 here. Then x 1, 1 here. X 2, 2 here. So the first term plus second term plus third term. So expansion here. Now you can see that the problem is simple. Equation is quite simple. And we can replace the values in this equation, and the value is 1, 2, 1. 1 is the first value, the remaining are 2 and 1. So when you will put these values in this equation, you will find that it is 1 by 3. First is 1 dot e to the power 0, the second is what, 2 dot e to the power minus j 2 pi by 3 k plus 1 dot e to the power minus j 2 pi by 3 dot 2 k. So it will become 4 k. Alright, from this equation to this equation, what I did, I have replaced the value of x0, x1, x2 from given data. Now you simplify this equation, you will find fixed values here, that this equation is what, from this equation, if you will put the value here of k, you will be able to find out the complete length of Fourier coefficient. Now k is between 0 to n minus 1. So for k equal to 0, it will become c0. Equation will become 1 by 3. 1 plus 2 plus 1. So that is what 2 plus 1, 4 by 3. Now for k equal to 1, equation will become c1 equal to 1 by 3. First equation 1, the second k equal to 1, you write it will become 2 dot to the power of minus j 2 pi by 3 plus 1 dot to the power of minus j 4 pi by 3 and k equal to 1. Then you write here k equal to 2 c2 1 by 3 1 plus 2 to the power of minus j 2 pi by 3 plus 1 dot. Now this time k is equal to 2, so we write 2 here. We multiply 2 into 2, it will become 4 here. And this will become to the power of minus j 8 pi by 3. C0, C1, C2. So, this is C0, C1, C2. These are the Fourier coefficient for given sequence, periodic sequence, discrete time. So, using C0, C1, C2, we can find out their exact value. And the value of C0, C1, C2 spectrum bar can be calculated using the simple processor, and that is what C of M mod of C of K and angle of C of K. Mod of C of K and angle of C of K. So mod of C0, mod of C1, C2 will be the magnitude part, and angle of these things will be the frequency part. So ultimately the main idea behind this Fourier series calculation is to find out the spectral part, and this side, mod of C of K is known as amplitude spectrum, and angle of C of K is known as a magnitude or you can say phase spectrum. We will plot the graph of angle of C of K with respect to omega. We will plot the graph of C of K, mod of C of K with respect to omega. These two graphs combined we will also known as a frequency spectrum. Separately we can call it amplitude spectrum or phase of frequency spectrum. But normally whenever we are finding that frequency spectrum is given of a problem, we expect that the magnitude will be given and angle will be given to us. So, as an examiner or as a subject teacher, the expectation from me will be what in case of Fourier series, you will ultimately find out mod of C of K and C of, angle of C of K. Once you have find out this angle of C of K and mod of C of K, the next thing is to put these values into the standard equation again. And that equation was another formula here, and that was what you can see, it was x of n is equal to summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1 c of k to the power j 2 pi by capital N small n and k. Now for k equal to 0, in our case it is up to 3 only, so 0, 1, 2, 3. So what I will do, I will write up to 3. N minus 1 was there, so 3 minus 1 I will write, and this will become 2. So I will write 0 to 2. So if you will open this equation, if you will open this summation, this will become again C0 e to the power 0. We are replacing the value of k. C1 e to the power j 2 pi by 3 small n plus C2 e to the power j 2 pi by 3. And with that, 2 n small n. Now C0, C1, C2 we have calculated in last case. The same value we will put here, C0, C1, C2, C3. Right hand side I will write x of n. So this is what Fourier series expansion of a given problem. This is Fourier series expansion of a given problem. So using this method we can calculate Fourier series expansion for any discrete time periodic signal, and remember it is only applicable to periodic signals. So steps are like this: first of all you test periodicity, then find out the Fourier series coefficient, then ultimately you put the values into the equation or standard formula. So this is all about discrete time Fourier series from your course mentioned.